The can of air freshener on top of the casket was there for good reason. The deceased had been dead for 4 days. His face was visible through a window in the lid of the casket. People had come from near and far to pay their respects. A deep hole waited to receive the coffin and its occupant. No one was in any doubt at all. The man was dead. As I took in the scene in a small African village, I thought of the famous Bible story. Jesus arrived at the home of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus 4 days after Lazarus had passed away. Lazarus was as dead as the man in the casket before me. But Jesus did something I could not. He spoke to the lifeless body of his friend and instructed him to rise. "Lazarus, come forth," Jesus commanded. At the sound of the voice of his friend, Jesus, Lazarus rose from his resting place in the tomb and came out of that cold, dark place. Jesus simply spoke four little words, and a dead man lived. Imagine what it will be like at the resurrection when Jesus speaks to the sleeping saints of all ages and calls them forth from their dusty beds. That great day is spoken of by the prophet Isaiah when he writes, "I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, keep not back. Bring my sons from far and my daughters from the ends of the earth." Isaiah 43:6. The Bible describes death as an enemy, but it's an enemy that will one soon day finally and forever be eradicated. No more death. When Jesus returns, long anticipated reunions will take place. Relationships that have been sundered by death will be rekindled. Not only will the saved meet relatives from previous generations, but they'll meet patriarchs, prophets, pioneers, and Jesus himself. What a day that resurrection day will be. And it won't be long now. Walk with Jesus, yield your heart to him today, and you can look forward to that day. I'm John Bradshaw for It Is Written.